الأجداد قد عظمت فللأمجاد بانيها ومن يسعى إلى العلم.
And then he said the second hadith is the hadith that Anas relates رضي الله عنه أبو حمزة when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه. From the beautiful Islam of a Muslim, of a person, is to mind his own business. To mind his own business. A man once asked Imam Shafi'i, asked Imam Malik. A man once asked Imam Shafi'i, how old are you? Come Umrah, how old are you? Imam Shafi'i said, أقبل على شأنك, mind your own business. And the man said, I was just asking your age. He said, I asked Imam Malik how old he was, and he said to me, أقبل على شأنك. There's a hadith, مسلسل, أقبل على شأنك, that the ulama give by مسلسل. Each scholar says, أقبل على شأنك. Mind your own business. Imam al-Ghazali said, the business of the scholar is scholarship. The business of the mechanic is to fix things. The business of the doctor is the bodies. Mind your own business. Do what you are trained to do. But don't get into other things. One of the Salaf passed by a beautiful house and he said, MashaAllah, whose house is this? And the man told him, and then he began to weep because it was just fudul of kalam. He's just asking about something that had no, he had no business asking it. This is the muraqabah, the vigilance of these people and their tongues. Now we have people giving, going online and commenting and big ulama and saying what's haram and what's halal and who's Muslim and who's not. This is the type of age we're living in where people are not minding their own business. They're preoccupied with everything but their own business. Mind your own business. I was with one of the Shuk Sheikh Al-Sawi, and we were in California, and a man said to him, what do you say about this, that, or the other? And he said something, and the man said, but Allah says, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمَ الْكَافِرُونَ. But if you don't rule by the ruling of God, you are from amongst the kuffar. Sheikh Sawi, who's a hafiz of the Qur'an, he said, MashaAllah, could you just remind me, what was the verse before that verse? He didn't say anything. He said, what's the verse after it? Because I want to know the context. He didn't say anything. He said, brother, what do you do? He said, I'm an auto mechanic. He said, fix cars. Really? Because to speak about God is the most egregious sin that you can commit. It's actually, according to Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, in I'lam al-Muwaqqi'een, it's worse than shirk. To speak about God without knowledge. وَأَن تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ رَبَّعَهُ فِي الْآيَةِ. It was the last thing mentioned in the ayah. Because it's the worst thing that you can do. Shirk is speaking about God what you don't know. So it's part of it. But this is what's happened. We have people who have no training. They haven't sat with scholars. Because the religion is meant to be protected. Mind your own business. Mind your own business. Think about what ماذا يعنيك. What concerns you as an individual? What is your purpose? What are you doing here? What concerns you? Not all these other things that people are concerned about.
محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين والفريقين من عرب ومن عجم. محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين والفريقين من عرب ومن